covering the Palm Beaches and the Treasure Coast. This is WPBF 25 News at 11.
Good evening, I'm Tiffany Kenny.
I'm Victor Blackwell. People in the Bahamas and the Carolinas are preparing for Hurricane Irene. It's expected to hit the Bahamas tomorrow. Mike Lyons is in the First Alert Weather Center. Mike, it looks like we will not feel a direct hit. So what will we feel?
We will begin to feel some rain tomorrow afternoon and tomorrow night, some gusty winds. The biggest impact for us will be along our coastline, some incredible surf beginning tomorrow night and really kicking into high gear on Thursday. But this storm is going to be one for the history books. Already tonight on the Turks and the Caicos, winds have gusted to 107 miles per hour. This is likely to become a Category 3 storm, a major hurricane, as it moves through the southern, central, and northern Bahamas, then the Carolinas, and then the big cities in the Northeast. All told, 80 million people may be affected by Hurricane Irene. Tonight, still a Category 1 storm. However, pressure continuing to drop. Hurricane hunters, they've been flying through the storm for the past several hours. They've noted a consistent drop in pressure. Ordinarily, it takes 4, 5, maybe 6 hours for the winds to respond to that drop in pressure. Tomorrow morning, this will be a Cat 2. Tomorrow night, it'll be a Category 3 major hurricane. Look what it's doing to the Turks and Caicos. One dot right here, wave height 28 feet. And on this island here, here are the Caicos. This is Grand Turk. Winds tonight, 107 miles per hour. Why is it going to get stronger? Number one, water temperature. All around it, toasty bath water, 84, 85, and 86 degrees. Why hasn't it gotten stronger? It can't breathe fully. Tonight, we've got a lot of ventilation here. The outflow looking good, but the outflow on the southern part of the storm being blocked by the big mountains of Hispaniola. As the storm moves away from those mountains, it will literally blow up. Tonight, certainly a significant storm, packing winds of 90 miles per hour. Here's the forecast track from the Hurricane Center, pretty much unchanged. They have it well east of us, then coming very close to the Carolinas as we head toward Friday, and after that, moving up the eastern seaboard of the United States. Now, let's compare the forecast track with the computer models. They came out earlier tonight, and you can see it's pretty much the same. The models have not budged, so it looks like maybe 80 million people could be affected by this storm. Back to our maps for just a second. We'll wrap up our coverage with a reminder that now's the time, if you have not done so, to download our free WPBF 25 Hurricane app. It's for the Apple at the Apple App Store and also at the Android market. Now, coming up, we're going to talk specifically about what impact the storm will have here on South Florida, how much rain we'll get, what kind of wind will move our way, and what about that high surf and the possibility of beach erosion? And, of course, Victor and Tiffany, your 7-day forecast.